Hello everyone, welcome to soundproofguide.com. In this video, I'll be talking about how to soundproof a garage. But really, where you should start is the garage door. And for whatever reason, a lot of people decide to soundproof the garage because they want to use that room as a hobby room and not just a room to store their cars. So there's three main reasons why you would want to soundproof a garage. First would be to block noise from leaving the garage. Let's say you have a band and you practice in the garage. Well, it's good that the sound won't disturb the neighbors quite as much. Another reason would be to block the sound coming in from outside. Of course, if you're using your garage as some sort of hobby room, and there's a lot of noise coming from outside for whatever reason, could it be traffic noise? You'd want to block a lot of that sound from coming in. And of course, the third reason would be to improve the overall sound in the garage, because most garages don't really have anything on the walls except for shelves and a few things on the shelves, and maybe some tools hanging on the wall. But other than that, we don't usually have pictures or paintings or things like that on the wall that would help absorb sound. So usually in a garage, there's a lot of echo. You've most likely noticed that if you turned on an air compressor in the garage versus outside. It's incredibly loud in the garage because of the poor sound quality. So now, of course, we'll have to talk about some factors that you will need to consider. So the first thing to look for is, well, what type of garage door do you have? Because you'll need to consider, what is the door actually made of? And how it opens? Is it a swing up door or a door that folds? And how often do you open it? Is it a door that you open every day? Or is it a door that you never open? Because that will completely change the way you soundproof the door. Because if you want to soundproof a door that you open every day, especially the folding ones, there's not a lot you can do to the door. But if it's a door that swings open, there's another few things that you can do. But also, if you never open your door, well, then you're free to basically block off the door completely if you never want to use it again. So that's something to consider. Another thing to look for is, how was your garage built? What type of material was used? Was it used with metal to concrete to wood? Was it insulated or not insulated? Because the type of material that your garage was built with will affect the type of soundproofing that you can use to most effectively soundproof the garage. So for example, let's say you have a garage with concrete walls with no insulation, is to add sound absorbing material on the wall to decrease the reverberation. Another thing to look for is, how many windows and doors do you have in your garage? Because that will also determine the effectiveness of your soundproofing, because that is where most of the sound comes into a room. So let's first look at the door, the garage door. If you have a large budget, one thing that I would consider if you have an uninsulated garage door is to completely replace it with a fully insulated door. This will not only help in reducing sound from coming in and out of the garage, but it will also help with climate control inside the garage to help with electricity costs. Of course, this is not the most budget-friendly way to go, but I have to mention this because, of course, it would be the most effective thing to do to soundproof the door. Now, if you have the type of door that folds up, first thing to look for is, look at the bottom. Look at how the door is sealed to the bottom. A lot of the times, the two corners are chewed up by rodents. So make sure that the corners are fully sealed as well. Completely replace it with a new one, and that will at least ensure that the bottom is sealed without any noise coming in. If you have the type of door that swings upright, this is the easiest type of door to soundproof, because you can actually put some panels on the door on the inside and it won't affect the door whatsoever. It will make it a little bit heavier, but you can buy some panels that will help insulate the door from sound and also from heating and cooling. I'll have a link in the description below of an insulation kit that you can buy from Home Depot that works really good.
If you like this type of content, consider subscribing to my channel. I would also appreciate you leaving a comment if you have any soundproofing questions or comments for me to answer. I will provide links to each and every one of these products I talk about in this video in the description below for you to purchase. And now back to the video.
So the next thing to do to soundproof the garage would be to add some acoustic panels on the wall. Now, you don't have to buy these types of panels. You can buy some types of panels that are hard and they actually look like paintings almost. But you can buy these. These types of panels are a lot less expensive and you can have them come in all sorts of different designs. And what this will do, as I mentioned earlier, if you have some sort of machinery inside a garage, if you're going to use it as a workshop, you'll want to have something on the wall to help absorb the sound because it will help reduce the echo by quite a lot. Once that's all done, the next thing you'll have to do is soundproof the windows and the man door of the garage. You can click a link above for about 15 ways on how to soundproof a door. So right now I'll just give you a couple of budget-friendly ways that will get you on the way to soundproof the door. The first thing that you can do that I would recommend is to change the door sweep. A lot of the time, a door sweep that's attached on a door that goes outside because of weather affecting it will become brittled in the bottom and will have a crack also on the bottoms and sometimes on the sides. So you'll want to change that. And what you will want is something very sturdy, very rubbery at the bottom that creates a perfect seal. The next thing that you would do is to add a weather strip around the door. Most likely you'll already have a weather strip because it's a door that goes outside, but changing that weather strip with something maybe better will help also seal the door even more. The one that I recommend is the same type of weather strip almost that you'll see in a car on the inside of a car door where it's a softer rubber that squishes. So that's the type of weather strip that I would personally use on a door like that. Now, to soundproof the window, use the weather strip also to soundproof the window. But what I would also use to soundproof the window is an acoustic caulking around the window casing, around the window frame, because a lot of the times with shifting, there will be cracks on the sides of the window frame and the window. So what you should do is add an acoustic sealant. Now, the difference between an acoustic sealing and just regular caulking is a lot of the regular caulking, the cheaper ones, will crack over time, but the acoustical sealants are made specifically so that they don't dry up and crack over time. They stay quite rubbery and works well to stop sound. Now, that was pretty simple. So let's say you have thin windows. One easy way to soundproof that window is to install some noise dampening curtains. These curtains are typically thicker, heavier than regular curtains. They're also called blackout curtains on a lot of different places. And these will not only block the light, they won't only block the UV rays from going onto your car, it will also block a lot of the sound. Just make sure that when you install them, that you have at least 6 inches on the top and bottom and on both sides covered away from the window with the curtain so that the sound doesn't easily come inside or go outside. If you don't really have the budget for soundproofing curtains, one of the easiest things to do is just to buy moving blankets. They're quite inexpensive, they're thick, they're heavy, and they will help block a lot of the sound. Now, they usually don't come with grommets to easily hang them. So what I've done in the past is use Velcro. You can use industrial Velcro. Yes, the blanket is heavy, but with buying a more expensive Velcro, you'll find that it will hold it. The only thing though, you'll have to sew one strip of Velcro onto the blanket because the self-adhesive strip will not stick on the material. So if you sew it on and then put the other adhesive strip around the window frame, easily stick it right on it while you need it, and when you don't need it, you just take it off, fold it up, put it on a shelf, forget about it. It works really well and it's quite inexpensive to do. So I would recommend that if you're looking to soundproof that window. You can also do that with the door. If you found that it works great with the window, you can buy a larger moving blankets and just maybe sew two together, fold them up, make them the shape of the door, put some Velcro on it, stick it right there, and you're good to go. I'm talking about the man door. But I guess you could do that also with the garage door. If it's a single garage door, you could do that, but it would be kind of a little bit more complicated, I guess, in some ways. Another thing with the curtains or with the moving blankets, it also acts as a sound absorber. So if that's all you have, if you have a big window on one side of the wall and you add that on the wall, that will help a lot in making the sound inside your garage sound better. So kills two birds with one stone, and it's pretty inexpensive to do. And the last thing to do is to soundproof the walls. If you already have everything finished, the finished walls, one thing that I would do is to add a second layer of drywall. It's quite simple to do. It's not fairly difficult. All you do is you buy the drywall and make sure that you get a thicker drywall, not the half inch that most people use, but buy the 5/8 inch drywall. It's thicker, it's sturdier, it has less chance of bowing, and it just looks better, and the added thickness will help in noise reduction by quite a lot. There's a link popping up here explaining the difference between half inch and 5/8 inch drywall for soundproofing a wall or a ceiling. So make sure to watch that video for more information. Another thing you'll see in that video is ways to implement the new drywall with other soundproofing material to make a better soundproofing on the wall overall. One thing that you can do to soundproof the wall even more is to add something like a green glue noise proofing compound. Now, how to install this is install, of course, the first layer of drywall. But in your case, if you have a finished wall, the first layer of drywall is already on. Now, the second is position the second drywall panel on the floor, insert the tube into a standard caulk gun, and dispense on panel in a uniform and random pattern, leaving between 2 and 3 inch border to allow for handling. Install the second layer of drywall within 15 minutes of putting the green glue on it, staggering the joints if possible, and fasten the screws per local building codes. Now, of course, this type of soundproofing material is not a miracle maker, but for the price and what it does, it's actually worth looking into, especially if you don't have a big wall. Now, you'll need 2 tubes per layer of drywall, and 1 tube costs between $15 and $20. So if you have the budget for it, it is something that I would recommend. If you're already going to put a second layer of drywall, you might as well put that. Now, another thing that you could do is to put some mass-loaded vinyl. If you do put mass-loading vinyl, it does work a little bit better than the green glue, of course, but it is a lot more expensive for a roll of this stuff. So it is something to look at. If you don't really know what mass loading vinyl is, I have a video that explains everything about mass loading vinyl, what it's made of, if it's safe, if it's toxic, how much it costs, where can you get it, what does it do, the pros, the cons, everything. So make sure to go watch that video to learn about this pretty cool soundproofing material. And the last thing that you can do to soundproof the wall is something that I've done myself, is build a huge rack on the biggest wall, of course, without windows or doors. Now, this racking that I built takes up the entire wall, and a lot of the stuff on the racks will both absorb sound because of the material it's made of, and will also block a lot of the sound going from the garage into the house, because that is the adjoining wall leading inside the house. So all of that stuff on the wall is helping a lot regarding soundproofing from noise coming inside the house. And this racking was all built by just scrap material, extra plywood that I had, and extra 2x4s and 4x4s left over. So if you built a deck, use some of that wood and make your own shelves. They're a lot sturdier most of the time, and it'll take the entire wall if you build it right. So that's about it really to soundproof a garage. Also, you might want to soundproof the ceiling if you have bedrooms above. And thank you again for watching. Thank you very much for watching. As I said before, if you like this type of content, consider subscribing to our channel, and also don't hesitate to leave us a comment with all of your soundproofing questions. I will do my best to answer all of them. Thank you very much for watching, and goodbye.